The easiest way to make a pinhole projection is with two pieces of white paper, or preferably something a little more durable, like white cardstock, what I have here. And all you're going to do is poke a hole in one piece of the cardstock. You're gonna hold it up to the sun, let the light shine through it, and it'll come through onto the other piece of white paper that you'll have on the ground or somewhere else outside. Now, you could just poke a hole directly into the middle of the paper itself, but if you're able to, a better way to do this is to actually cut about a 1 to 2 inch square or rectangle in the center of one piece of the cardstock and then put tin foil there to poke the hole through. I'll show you what I mean. You're gonna cut a hole in the center of one piece of your cardstock, and you can kind of fold the paper a little bit to make cutting a bit easier, so that you end up with something like this. And it doesn't need to be too big. Something around that size will do just fine. You're gonna wanna cut a piece of tin foil big enough to fit on that hole that you cut out of that cardstock or that piece of white paper. And you're simply just going to tape the tin foil over that paper. And you're going to cover the hole nice and tightly with tape all around. And you can use any kind of tape for this. Doesn't have to be scotch tape. It could be masking tape, duct tape. You could even use glue if you felt like gluing it to the paper. Just gotta wait for it to dry. And then what you should have is something that looks like this. Now you take your pin and you simply poke a hole right through the center of that tinfoil. Careful not to poke yourself. You're gonna take your two pieces of paper, the plain white paper as your backdrop, as your projection screen, and the one that has the tinfoil with the poked hole, that's going to be your pinhole. And what you're gonna do is make sure you angle this up towards the sun so that the sun is coming through that hole, and you're gonna see the image of that sun as a little white circle appearing on your paper. And the bigger the paper, the better. And the bigger the paper that you poke the hole into, the better, because it provides more shade and more shadow and a darker area to help make that image of the sun a little bit clearer. Now, if you don't have time to craft anything, you don't have access to eclipse glasses, you can use anything from your home that has holes in it. A strainer works great, a cheese grater. All of these things will also show the same type of effect as the projection devices that we've been showing you here. And I'll show you why it's so important to have that white paper as a backdrop. If you hold this up and you try to look at what it's showing on the ground, you can't see it very clearly against the grass. Even against pavement, it wouldn't come out that clear. But notice what happens as soon as I slip that white sheet underneath. You get a nice, crisp image, and you'll be able to much better see the sun being projected through those holes, and eventually the little bite being taken out of that sun's light as the shadow of the moon starts to move in between the sun and the earth. A strainer, colander, works the same way. You could also poke several holes into a piece of paper, like what I showed you with the white cardstock. You could hole punch some holes into a piece of paper, maybe punch your name, create different designs, and you can play around with holding things further or closer, seeing how much sharper the image becomes, how blurry the image becomes, depending on how far you're holding it from your screen. But you can easily find things just around the house, kitchen utensils, to make this work as well.